If you're just learning to write and you're just approaching writing for the first time, say, before you can begin to even consider writing a worship song that other people would sing, it's important to start to pour out your own thoughts and your own heart and learn how to articulate for yourself. If you were going to write a speech for a president, let's say, it'd be super important that you knew his voice and knew his language, knew his audience, knew so much about him so that you could actually represent him well. That would be like writing for the church, because you'd be writing for royalty, the bride of the Lord Jesus Christ, sons and daughters of the King Most High, if you were to write worship music for them to sing. You can't presume to do that if you haven't learned how to articulate simply for yourself and pour out your own heart. So let's talk about pouring out your own heart. Music is one of the things that has a way of just opening up your heart and soul. And to this day, science hasn't found anything like music insofar as it lighting up your brain. It has the ability to light up every single thing. So it's super healthy. Writing music is super healthy. The Lord tells us to sing a new song, all of us. Singing feels great to every person, not just singers, everybody. Everybody loves to sing. And all of us need to express ourselves. We all need to name our issues, name our disappointments, name our frustrations. Songwriting helps you to do that. It helps you to emote, helps you to be succinct, helps you to get it out on paper so you can then throw it away. That part's important, the throwing it away part. Oftentimes, when you're a brand new writer and you're young and you're excited because creativity happened, it's easy to want to show everybody your work, which is fine. It's easy to expect everybody to love it also because it was such a beautiful process for you. I want to add some realistic expectations to that. It says, make a joyful noise, Lord. Sing a new song. It's commanded over and over and over in Scripture. Doesn't say, everybody enjoy your song. Everybody enjoy each other's songs. It doesn't say that. Other people may not enjoy your music right away. When you're first learning to articulate, half the time they're laments, because we're actually trying to dig in deep and talk about oftentimes pain, because pain is what comes out in our writing. Well, when you walk up to meet somebody, you don't walk up and say, I'm super depressed. A lot of times our songs come across that way. Some of these ones you're gonna write initially, do yourself a favor, keep them to yourself. Keep them to you and the Lord, seriously. Keep them to you and the Lord. He's teaching you to write. He's teaching you how to be with him. Use songwriting to that end. Learn how to journal through music. It's, again, super healthy. You will remember what you write. And if it's gonna be super healthy all the way, then what you write becomes important. So as you're pouring your heart out before the Lord, as you're telling him what hurts you, remember the way that King David would do this. He would always tell everything that he was thinking to the Lord. He would tell all of the circumstances that were facing him to the Lord. If there was somebody that was gonna kill him, he'd tell the Lord all about it. If he was crying constantly, he would tell the Lord about his depression. But he would always circle back around and talk about God's goodness and God's nature. He never lost sight of who God was. And he would magnify the Lord. He wouldn't magnify his feelings, his emotions, and his circumstances. He would always go back and magnify God. The chorus of your song needs to be reserved for what is true all the time, all the time. Because that's the thing you're gonna remember the most. You're gonna sing it over and over and over. You wanna make sure you're speaking the truth to yourself. And you wanna tell yourself all the time who God is. So go ahead and emote. Emote your heart out in the verses. And then tell God about how much you trust him because of his character in the chorus. That's an easy beginner thing to do for songwriters. If you're going to write a verse and you're thinking in terms of each verse having four lines, okay? If the first line has 10 syllables, then the second verse, first line of the second verse needs to have 10 syllables also, and it needs to line up symmetrically. Da 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 da. If that's the first line for the first verse, the second verse, first line needs to be da 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 da. Symmetry, okay? Same holds true for the second line, first verse, second line, second verse. Third line, first verse, third line, second verse. Those are super beginner things. One final thing. You have to start somewhere. Pick a key, pick any chord. Start in that key. Decide, am I gonna do this in 4/4 or 3/4? Pick one. And then pick a starting note and go. It is that simple. Just go, start, just begin. There'll be more to follow.